How to use video balloons together with network cables for AHD CCTV camera installations and still be able to achieve effective video results. I will be explaining all the techniques involved in this process. These are AHD cameras. You can identify them by their B and C terminals. I'll show you how you can connect these cameras using a video balun together with Cat6 network cable instead of the traditional coaxial cable plus power. This is a pair of video balloons. It is normally bought as a pair because you require one at the point of entry into the DVR and one at the camera side. The balloons enable you to use Cat6 or Cat5 cables instead of coaxial cables to connect AHD or analog cameras. The balloons facilitate the connection of video into the camera, so you require DC power connectors for the power connection whenever you are using video balloons together with Cat5 or Cat6 cables. As you may already be aware, a Cat6 cable has 4 pairs of conductors, and so you will then decide which one or which pair to use for your video connection. I will use the green pair for this demonstration. So I will use the solid green as the positive video and the striped green as the negative video. The rest of the 3 pairs will be used for the power connection. I will show you how the combinations will be done. So let me start with the video connections. I will be using the solid green color as the positive video and the striped green as the negative video, as I mentioned earlier. So on the video balun, I will insert the solid green cable into the port corresponding to the red point, and the striped green goes into the port corresponding to the black mark. This balun is able to establish cable contact without having to peel the cable, so I will do the insertion without peeling the cable. So this means that this side is ready. Let's get to the other end of the cable. We will use the same green pair and by the same process insert the cables into the balloons. The positive video is the solid green and the striped green is the negative video. So our video terminations are ready for both ends of the cable. We will now be doing the power terminations using the rest 3 pairs of the cable. For the power terminations, there is need to peel the cables. Here are the peeled cables, and here is what we'll be doing next. By my choice, I would put the solid colors together and use them as the positive for the power connection. I will twist them together and trim it nicely. I will twist the striped colors too together. Get them trimmed nicely as well. So I'm ready with the DC power connector. I will be putting my solid colors into the indicated positive and the striped colors into the negative. I will first loose the power connector. You have to still check the positive and negative and then push in the cables very firmly. and tighten up using your screwdriver, making sure that they are very firm. So this means that this end of the cable is fully ready with the video balun and the power connection. Let's move to the other end of the cable. If you look at it as it is now, if we were using this power supply to power up the camera, all we would have done is to separate the positive and the negative terminals and slot it into the power bridge. But we will use this adapter to power up the camera. So because of that, I'll fix this DC connector on the cable so that the adapter can plug into it like this. Whilst the cable goes into this, power will be supplied to the camera when we turn on power to the adapter. I've gotten my cables peeled, so let me put them together. All the solid colors will be put together and twisted together. And then twist the striped ones together. You then trim them very well. We will now fix the female DC adapter to it. The negative comes here, and the positive. You will have to screw them firmly. So everything is ready. We will have to now connect it and get it tested. I will connect this end to the camera. And the power connection goes this way. Let's see the other end of the cable. That one will go into the DVR. The balun side connects video into the DVR. So I will connect it to any of the video inputs for the purposes of this tutorial. I'll connect this plugged adapter into this. Let me quickly connect a screen to test it for you to see. There you have it. The camera is on. Let me now explain the reasons why we had to combine the three pairs of conductors within the Cat6 cable that we use to transmit power to the camera. You know, carrying power over a distance requires considerably large cable cross-sectional area to be able to drive the power to its destination without having a drop in the voltage. In the case of the CCTV cameras, they require 12 volts DC, and using less than the three pairs of cables within the Cat6 cable could result in a drop in the voltage that is sent to the CCTV camera. When the voltage carried to the CCTV camera goes below a certain level, the camera cannot be turned on due to the low voltage supply. The most common causes of low voltage to CCTV cameras is the use of long cables with low cross-sectional area. It is therefore important to ensure that when using Cat6 or Cat5 cables, in the installation of AHD cameras, you combine multiple pairs of conductors within the Cat 5 or Cat 6 cable in order to avoid low voltage transmitted to the cameras and an eventual result of the camera not being able to get powered on. I will be very glad to have your questions on this particular topic. Thank you so much for watching this video. Please don't forget to subscribe to this channel. Thank you once again.